Hey everyone, I'm Howard Pinsky. I don't know about you, but I'm hooked on Squid Game, so I thought it would be a fun idea to create an invitation card in Adobe XD. Start off by selecting your rectangle tool, and draw one out in your desired size. Styling-wise, we'll round out the corners ever so slightly. Then the color should be set to a dark beige, which will interact really nicely with the textures we'll be adding in just a moment. To add a slight edge to the card, a dark border can be applied, with the opacity dropped to around 25%, and the size set to 4. Finally, we can add additional depth with an inner shadow. Instead of a dark tone, we'll go with something bright and slightly vibrant that complements the fill color. Then, similar to the border, the opacity can be dropped to blend in, somewhere around 40%. For this design, I'll want the highlight to hit the top and left sides of the card, so I'll bump both the X and Y values to around 8, then experiment with the blur until we're left with a nice subtle effect. Perfect. It's not looking that exciting just yet, but let's add in some textures to bring this to life. Duplicating this existing shape, I'll switch over to one of my Creative Cloud libraries, where I've downloaded a few free Adobe Stock assets, which I'll link in the description of this video. The first image we're going to bring in will be this cardstock texture. And once it's been placed into the shape, I'll turn off the unneeded styles, then the blend mode can be set to either soft light or overlay, depending on the color of the card in the background. Next, let's add a touch of grunge. Duplicating one more time, I'll drag in the next texture. Then instead of overlay, the blend mode should be switched to multiply to hide the lighter areas of this image. Then if the effect feels too strong, the opacity can be dropped to around 60%. You can also get away with color burn if you prefer more of a burnt look. Finally, and this one is pretty optional, one more texture can be applied to add a few lighter scratches. And since we'll want to hide the darker tones here, screen with a lower opacity should do the trick. Alright, the look and feel of this card is complete, but we're missing the most important element, the symbols. Luckily, these are created using very basic shapes. So with the ellipse, polygon, and rectangle tools, I'll go through and draw out one of each, holding down Shift to constrain their proportions. Once they've been created, we can start lining up our shapes, which you might think would be pretty simple, but the curved ellipse to the left throws us a bit of a curveball. Currently, there's 24 pixels in between each shape, but visually, the ellipse looks much further than the square, so we'll need to bring it on in to visually line all three up. With those now set, let's get them styled. Selecting all three shapes, I'll start by turning off the fill, then setting the border to a dark gray. We'll want to avoid pure black since it'll make blending a touch more difficult. Sizing-wise, somewhere around 18 works for this example, but you may need to increase or decrease depending on the size of your shapes. Next, let's add a subtle drop shadow. But instead of a dark shadow which will separate these shapes from the card, we want a lighter shadow with a hint of orange. This will help give the impression that the symbols are embedded into the cardstock. You'll likely have to experiment with the Y, blur, and opacity values until you land on something that looks believable. Perfect. The last thing we'll want to tackle is blending. Quickly placing these symbols into a group with Command and Control G, I'll shift them behind the texture layers, which already looks pretty good, but we can use a blend mode like overlay or hard light for an extra kick. And if desired, brightening or darkening the gray, and in some cases adding in a touch of color, can tweak the effect even further. Now, if you really want to take this effect to another level, the strokes of the symbols can be outlined under the object menu. Then a 4-pixel border on the center can be added. Setting the color of this border on the lighter side with a decreased opacity will add a nice ridge around the shapes. We can then add in a subtle inner shadow, making sure it's on the darker side so it's visible against the fill color. And since the shapes are somewhat small, we won't need to bump the Y value too much, and we'll want to keep the blur fairly low. Finally, a very subtle object blur can be applied, and if one seems too high, entering a value like 0.5 may work better. And that'll wrap it up, your very own Squid Game invitation card. But there's always more you can do with a design like this. If you're feeling adventurous, check out my video on how to create a card flip animation using 3D transforms. And if you do put it to use, shoot me a tweet with your design, I'd love to check them out. Thanks so much for watching everyone, hope you all enjoyed this video, subscribe for more content, and I'll see you all next time.